Hi, what's your name?
Lauren Fisher.
Where are you at right now?
Carlsbad CrossFit.
What's going on today?
I'm going to meet this girl, Rachel, for her 14th birthday.
And something special about that?
Yeah, because she looks up to me, and so I think just like working out with her and I guess getting to meet her, it's a surprise.
Hi, I'm Lauren. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
How long have you been doing CrossFit?
About a year and a half.
Someone tells me that you look up to this young lady over here.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Lauren Fisher.
How did you find out about Lauren Fisher?
I watched one of her videos, the Growing Up Strong video.
And what did you say to yourself?
I want to be like her.
And did you know she was walking through the door right now?
No.
How long do you hold this for?
Just until...
You feel warm?
Yeah.
That's what I do.
Pigeon stretch.
Oh, I do pigeon stretch also. This is like, looks like my warm up.
Yeah. What's your deadlift, Rachel? 240.
What? Wait, what?
That's crazy.
Come on. Come on, Rachel. Come on, baby. Yeah, pull it.
She did Filthy 50 for fun on Sunday, wanted to work out again, did Ollie stuff on Monday. We actually said, you're doing just techniques.
She has like just a go-get-it spirit. She just wants to keep going.
She's made the comment before that, you know, why don't you go do soccer? Why don't you do some gymnastics? Do a different sport. And she just says, no, I want to win the games. This is what I want to do. She's 100%. There is no... middle ground. It's 0 to 100 miles an hour. We have to hold her back without questions.
She has a school record in her junior high for push-ups. So what did you get, Rach?
Was it 2 years ago? 50.
50 straight.
Oh my God.
How many?
50 push-ups.
She petitioned with her middle school to do ISPE, which is Independent Study Physical Education. So she comes to CrossFit for her PE.
Yeah,
her school district does it. I'm not sure if it's new or not. I know some school districts do it. So she was able to petition. So basically, semi-annually, I submit a progress report. And
how's her grade?
Her grade's pretty good. You know, she sets goals at the beginning of the semester. And by the end, we just evaluate to see where she was in her goals. So
when you come down into the second one, what happens?
I catch too high, and I don't really know how to transition it.
She's stop. Because when you're up here and then you come down, like you come down like this. Mm-hmm. Have you ever like tried to just fall out of your muscle up and just go into the next one? Fall right into your next one. Yeah. There we go.
There you go. Up.
When did you realize you had like a little future gamer firecracker right there?
As soon as I put rings up in the gym in a pull-up bar, I knew I did. I mean, she worked so hard at doing her pull-ups and then handstand push-ups. She started working with books up against the wall. She'd do this every night, and we'd start pulling one book out, another book out, another book out. She got to the point where she did 17 strict handstand push-ups in a row. I have a videotape of it, and this was a couple of years ago.
And you're a dad.
I'm dad, yeah.
That sounds like a proud dad to me.
Man, I'm stoked.
Your kids,
yeah, it's amazing. I'm really, it's really been an incredible bonding experience for both of us. I mean, this is all we talk about. And I come home at night, we watch CrossFit videos, mainly Fisher over there, and you know, that's her thing. She doesn't like to watch TV. She wants to watch CrossFit videos. We go over technique. I watch her every day. If I don't work out with her, I'll take her to a later class, but I'll come early and watch her, and then after, she wants critiquing.
So you're basically just dropping down, no bend of the knees. Yeah.
She's really, really athletic, very, very strong young lady. So we just want to make sure that she has that technique. So obviously, you know, you get a long wad, some of these chippers and that sort of stuff. Got to be efficient, got to have your technique. And that's going to pay off big dividends in the future for her, I think. So.
One power snatch. So two muscle snatches for the hang, one muscle snatch, full muscle snatch, and then one power snatch. Two of those.
You primarily train morning, afternoon, evenings?
Right now, since I'm training for the CrossFit Games, morning, afternoon, and night.
All three.
Yeah.
And so high hang snatch. And then we'll do mid thigh. And then full snatch.
I imagine a world where the parents are the ones pushing the children. Usually that's what I picture when I think of child athletes. I think of the parents driving the kid, and this is like the opposite.
Yeah, no, she definitely drives me to work out constantly. She won't take a rest day. She'll go 7 days a week if I let her. So I definitely try to get her to rest once or twice a week. I mean, last night I told her to take a rest, and she did today's WOD last night on her own.
Nice. So just make sure you punch up and be super aggressive.
She's very shy, so this has helped her come out of her box.
Yeah, no, she's a quiet young lady.
Yeah, she is, but she's very animated when she's in here, and she's comfortable, and it's been really good for her.
Yeah, I'm very quiet, but when you get to know me, I'm louder.
She has a CrossFit Games athlete right now coaching.
I know, it's fantastic. She couldn't be more stoked. She's so happy. I mean, she was in the kids CrossFit here, but she's so good that they put her in the adult classes. So she only does adult and blows them all away.
You want to do what she's doing? CrossFit Games?
Yeah.
This is her first year going to the CrossFit Games as an individual?
Yeah.
And you could do that one day if you put your mind to it.
Yeah.
It just takes hard work. You got it? If you keep going like you're going, it's not that far-fetched to think if she made it to the CrossFit Games as 17 or 18.
I'd be 24 if she made it when she was 18.
So, I mean, we could be staring at potentially two athletes.
I know, it's really cool to see.
3, 2, 1, go.
Get it, Rage, come on. Come on, Rage.
CrossFit to you?
It's everything. I love to do it, and I don't know what I'd do without it.
Individual this
I think
year?
The biggest thing for her to take away is to never take it too seriously, and if you're not hitting your PR numbers or if you're not maybe progressing at a certain time, to not get down on yourself and feel like it's the end of the world and feel like you have to work on everything.
Who's the founder of CrossFit?
Greg Glassman.
What's your favorite WOD?
Like a named workout?
Yeah, sure.
I like Diane.
I said Diane's my favorite workout.
Is it?
Yeah.
So you're a smart kid?
I wouldn't say I'm smart, I'm just hardworking, so.
There you go, got it. Good job, honey. Gonna go for 5? No. Bring bring those rings in. Kip, big Kip, big Kip. Wait, Kip, come on, Kip it out, Kip it out.
How old will you be qualifying for your first regionals?
17 or 18.
All right.
17 years old, lock it in.
Lock it in. It's all high five. You know, yeah. Still tomorrow.
Yeah, I won't forget this for sure.
Full extension. Serious business now. Be an athlete. Up, 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 up.